Hello friends, welcome to SSP Math. Today we are going to start most important topic of differential equation, that is applications of linear differential equation with constant coefficient, in which we will learn one application of civil engineering. That application is bending moment. For civil engineering, another applications are also applicable, that is mass spring system. But in our syllabus, only one application is given, that is bending moment. And for making this video, I have referred Higher Engineering Mathematics by H.K. Das. So first we will see what is meant by beam. And now you are the civil engineers, so you know beam. But how to define the beam? So beam means a bar whose length is much greater than its cross section and its thickness is called a beam. A bar whose length much greater than, suppose here AB is beam given, so length of this beam is say x, so length is x and thickness is say this, so length is greater than its thickness, so this AB is called as beam. Now the beam, there are three types of beam. First one is supported beam, second one is fixed beam, and third one is cantilever beam. Now what is mean by supported beam? Supported beam means if a beam may just rest on a support like a knife edge is called a supported beam. A beam may just rest on a support. Means suppose this is one beam and this beam is support on these two knives. Okay, simply supported. Okay, so such type of beams are called as supported beam. Okay, the second one is fixed beam. Fixed beam means if one or both ends of a beam are firmly fixed, means either one end is fixed or both end are fixed, so such type of beams are called as fixed beam. For example, this is one beam and suppose this end is fixed or also this end is fixed. Okay, so such type of beams are called as fixed beam. And third most important type of beam is, that is cantilever beam. Cantilever beam means if one end of beam is fixed and other end is loaded. One end is fixed and other end is loaded. For example, this is one beam. So one end is fixed here. One end means this end is fixed, say left end is fixed, okay, and another end is loaded, means if we apply some force on this end, then we get here some deflection. Okay, so another end is loaded or apply force F suppose here. So such type of beams are called as cantilever beam. Okay, now we will start bending moment. So what is mean by bending moment? So bending moment means whenever a beam is loaded, it deflects from its original position. बराबर है ना? Suppose एक beam है, ये beam दिया है, इस पर कुछ load apply किया यहाँ पर, तो deflects होगा. Means it deflects. Suppose that deflection is this. It deflects from its original position. Okay? If capital M is the bending moment of the forces acting on it, if capital M is the bending moment of the forces acting on it, then we can write M is equal to E by R into I, where E is modulus of elasticity of the beam, I is moment of inertia of cross section of beam about neutral axis, and capital R is radius of curvature of the curved beam. So where capital R is radius of curvature, so we can write capital R is equal to 1 upon d2y by dx square. Okay, so if you put here capital R here, then we can write bending moment M is equal to EI into d2y by dx square. So we have to use this formula for solving problems. Okay, the next one is boundary conditions. For boundary conditions are very important for solving problems. So first condition is end freely supported. End freely supported means at the freely supported end, there will be no deflection at the freely supported end. There will be no deflection and no bending moment. Deflection means this y is deflection here. So at the freely supported end, deflection is 0, that is y is 0, and bending moment is also 0, means d2y by dx square is also 0. Fixed end horizontally. In fixed end horizontally, deflection and slope of the beam are 0. Slope is 0 means dy by dx equal to 0. Deflection is 0 means y equal to 0. And third one is perfectly free end. In perfectly free end, at the free end, there is no bending moment or shearing force. No bending moments means d2y by dx square equal to 0, and no shearing force means d3y by dx cube equal to 0. Okay, so this is the theory related part. Now we will take some problems on bending moment. So before taking problems, we will take one more definition of elastic curve. So what do you mean by elastic curve? Elastic curve means when a force act in a vertically, the beam due to elasticity is bent or distorted. So the resulting distorted axis of symmetry is called elastic curve. Means if you apply force vertically on beam, so that beam bent or distorted. Okay, so the resulting distorted axis of symmetry is called as elastic curve. So sometimes you have to find, maybe question is there, find elastic curve or equation of elastic curve. Okay, so now we will start problems. So first problem is the differential equation satisfied by a beam uniformly loaded with one end fixed. One beam given a and uniformly loaded with one end fixed and second end subjected to a tensile force P is given by EI into d2y by dx square minus py equal to minus wx square by 2. Show that the elastic curve for the beam under conditions y equal to 0, dy equal to 0 when x equal to 0, means at x equal to 0, y equal to 0, dy by dx equal to 0 here, is given by, so this is the equation of elastic curve, that is y equal to w upon 2p into bracket x square plus 2 by n square minus e raised to nx upon n square minus e raised to minus nx upon n square, where p by ei is equal to n square. So we will start now solution of this problem. Here differential equation is already given, so first we will write differential equation. So given differential equation is ei into d2y by dx square minus py is equal to minus wx square by 2, and p by ei equal to n square is given in problem. Now if we divide throughout by ei here, then this can be written as d2y by dx square minus p upon ei into y is equal to minus w by 2 ei into x square. Okay, and here p by ei equal to n square given is, if you put here, then this becomes d2y by dx square minus py is equal to minus w upon 2 ei into x square. Now if you use here capital D is equal to d by dx, what is this? This is the linear differential equation with constant coefficient. Okay, so if you take capital D is equal to d by dx, then we can write here d square y minus py, that is d square minus p into, so p by ei is equal to n square given, not p, so write here n square. Okay, so d square minus n square into y is equal to minus w upon 2 ei into x square. So what is this solution? Its solution is cf plus pi. So for cf we want auxiliary equation, and auxiliary equation is d square minus n square equal to 0. So if you find roots here, that roots are d is equal to plus or minus n. Okay, now roots are plus or minus n, so we can write cf is equal to c1 e raised to nx plus c2 e raised to minus nx. Now we have to find pi here. So pi is equal to 1 upon d square minus n square into f of x. F of x is this, that is minus w upon 2EI into x square. So here x square we have to replace x square means we have to use x raised to m formula. So for that we want 1 plus z or 1 minus z form here. So minus w upon 2EI constant take outside, and from this take minus n square common. So if you take minus n square common in bracket 1 minus d square upon n square is there into x square. Okay, so is equal to this minus minus plus w upon 2EI into n square into here 1 upon 1 minus d square by n square into x square, that is 1 upon 1 minus z. So what is 1 upon 1 minus z? 2EI n square. 1 upon 1 minus z formula is 1 plus z is 1 upon 1 plus d square by n square plus so on into x square. Neglect higher terms because third derivative of x square is 0, is equal to w upon 2EI n square into 1 into x square is x square plus d square of x square, second derivative of x square, first derivative is 2x, second derivative is 2. So 2 by n square. This is the PI. Now we can write final answer here, y is equal to CF plus PI. Now what is CF? CF is C1 e raised to nx plus C2 e raised to minus nx, and plus PI is w upon 2EI n square into x square plus 2 by n square. Now in problem, given that at x equal to 0, y equal to 0, dy by dx equal to 0. So using this we have to find c1 and c2. So for this we want dy by dx also. This is equation 1, say, and if you differentiate equation 1 with respect to x, then we get dy by dx is equal to derivative of e raised to nx is n into e raised to nx. Same derivative of e raised to minus nx is minus n into e raised to minus nx plus w upon 2EI n square as it is into derivative of this x square is 2x and derivative of 2 by n square is 0. Okay, now here this is equation 2, say. In 1 and 2, if you put x equal to 0, y equal to 0, dy by dx equal to 0, then equation 1 becomes y equal to 0 equal to c1 e raised to 0 is 1 plus c2 e raised to 0 is 1 and plus w upon 2EI n square into 2 upon n square. Okay, so using this we can write first equation c1 plus c2 is equal to this 2 to get cancelled minus w upon ei n raised to 4. And similarly in second, if you put x equal to 0 dy by dx equal to 0, then we get 0 is equal to nc1 minus nc2 and this is 0. So if you divide throughout by n, then n get cancelled, c1 minus c2 equal to 0. This is equation 3, say, and this is 4. So from 3 and 4 we have to find c1 and c2. So if we take addition of equation 3 and 4, then this c2 get cancelled, c1 plus c1 is 2c1 is equal to minus w upon ei n raised to 4. So c1 is equal to minus w upon ei n raised to 4 into 2. Okay, and c1 equal to c2, so this is also c2. Okay, now we have to put this c1 and c2 in y, and therefore y becomes c1. C1 is minus w upon 2EI n raised to 4 into e raised to nx minus w upon 2EI into n raised to 4 e raised to minus nx plus w upon 2EI n square into x square plus 2 by n square. So I think from this we can take w upon 2EI n square common, in bracket write down remaining terms, that is x square plus 2 by n square minus e raised to nx upon n square minus e raised to minus nx upon n square. And what we have to prove? We have to prove that w upon p,
W upon 2P. We want W upon 2P. Remaining terms we get here. So what is the value of P here? P by EI is equal to N square. So from this we can write P is equal to EI N square. So here this EI N square, if you put P, then we get W upon 2P into this. That is the required. Okay. So next problem is, a uniform cantilever beam of length L has a weight P at the free end. Find the equation of elastic curve, slope and deflection. So we have to find equation of elastic curve, means we have to find equation of bending moment, that is M is equal to EI into D2Y by DX square. What is M? M is the sum of forces. So first we have to find sum of forces here, that is net force M. Cantilever beam given. Cantilever beam means one end is fixed and another end is free to move. Okay, and force is given as weight P, means if we apply force P at the end B, and length of this beam given small l. Okay, then how we find moment at point B? We know that moment at point B is equal to force into length, that is at point B ke liye moment kya aayega? PL. Okay. यदि यहाँ से फोर्स अप्लाई किया तो सेम इधर रिएक्शन होगी. पी फोर्स अप्लाई किया तो एट पॉइंट ए के लिए रिएक्शन होगी. सो रिएक्शन एट पॉइंट ए क्या होती है? ए. ओके, सो उससे हम इक्वेशन लिखते हैं ई आई इंटू डी टू वाई बाई डी एक्स स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू माइनस एक्स इंटू रिएक्शन, माइनस एक्स इंटू रिएक्शन प्लस मोमेंट. ओके, सो इक्वल टू क्या आएगा? माइनस एक्स इंटू रिएक्शन एट पॉइंट पी इज पी एंड प्लस मोमेंट एट पॉइंट बी इज पी एल. सो दिस इज द इक्वेशन ऑफ इलास्टिक कर्व, दैट इज ई आई इंटू डी टू वाई बाई डी एक्स स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू पी एल माइनस पी एक्स. वट वी वॉन्ट? वी वॉन्ट स्लोप. ओके, स्लोप मीन्स फ्रॉम दिस वी हैव टू फाइंड डी वाई बाई डी एक्स. डी वाई बाई डी एक्स इज द स्लोप. So how we find dy by dx? By taking integration. So integrate this. If you take integration, then ei into integration of dy by dx, d2y by dx square is dy by dx is equal to pl constant a. Integrate with respect to x this. So pl into integration of dx is x minus p into integration of x is x square by 2 plus constant of integration is c1. ओके, सो इससे हम dy by dx लिख सकते हैं, दैट इज dy by dx इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन ई आई इंटू पी एल एक्स माइनस पी एक्स स्क्वायर बाय टू प्लस सी वन. सो सेकंड पार्ट इज ओवर हियर, विच वन? दैट इज स्लोप. देन वॉट टू फाइंड डिफ्लेक्शन. सो डिफ्लेक्शन के लिए अगेन वॉट टू इंटीग्रेट, मीन्स वी वॉन्ट y हियर. सो इंटीग्रेशन ऑफ dy by dx इज y इज इक्वल टू वन अपॉन ई आई इज कॉन्स्टेंट. PL constant A, integration of x is x square by 2 minus P by 2 constant A, integration of x square is x cube by 3 plus C1 constant A, integration of dx is x and plus another constant is C2. Okay, now in cantilever beam at x equal to 0 ke liye condition kya hoti hai? Boundary condition. X equal to 0 ke liye y 0 hota hai, deflection 0 hota hai, and deflection 0 aaya to slope bhi 0 hota hai. Dy by dx is also 0. So if we put here, then yaha par dekho dy by dx equal to 0 put kiya to 0 is equal to c1 milega direct. Okay, and same here, if you put y equal to 0, then 0 equal to here x present, here x present, here x present. So all terms get cancelled, c2. So c1 and c2 both are 0, and therefore what is the deflection then? Deflection is y is equal to 1 upon ei into pl x square by 2 minus px cube by 6. So from this we can take px square by 2 common. Okay, or if I take a P by 6 common, P by 6 into EI, then we get here 3 LX square minus X cube. So this is the equation of, or this is the deflection Y, and slope, slope mein yahan par C1 0 put karo, remaining term means that is dy by dx is equal to P by टू ई आई मीन्स यहाँ से मैंने पी बाई टू कॉमन लिया तो टू एल एक्स माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर ए मिला मुझे स्लोप. ओके सो नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम इज ऑन स्ट्रट. सो प्रॉब्लम इज द डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ ए स्ट्रट ऑफ लेंथ एल विथ वन एंड एट एक्स इक्वल टू जीरो फिक्स्ड एंड द अदर एंड सपोर्टेड एंड सब्जेक्टेड टू एंड थ्रस्ट पी सेटिस्फाइज द इक्वेशन डी टू वाई बाई डी एक्स स्क्वायर प्लस ए स्क्वायर वाई इक्वल टू ए स्क्वायर आर अपॉन पी इंटू एल माइनस एक्स वेयर ए आर पी आर कॉन्स्टेंट्स is a r p r constants then prove that the deflection of the curve is given by y is equal to r by p into sin ax upon a minus l cos ax plus l minus ax. So for solving this problem differential equation is given in problem, so we have to write only this differential equation and try to find its solution. Okay, so we will start now solution. So given differential equation is d2y by dx square plus a square y is equal to a square r upon p into l minus x. How we solve this differential equation? If you observe carefully, this is the linear differential equation with constant coefficient. So for solving this, we have to put capital D is equal to d by dx. So if you put here, then this becomes d square plus a square into y is equal to a square r upon p into l minus x. So what is auxiliary equation here? Auxiliary equation is equal to d square plus a square equal to 0. So if you find roots here, that roots are d is equal to plus or minus ai. Okay, and therefore cf is equal to c1 cos ax plus c2 sin ax. Now we have to find pi here. So for pi, we know that formula pi equal to 1 by phi. So phi is d square plus a square into f of x a square r by p into l minus x. So l minus x is algebraic function, so we have to use x raised to m formula here, shortcut method, that is a square r upon p into take a square common 1 plus d square upon a square into l minus x. So degree of l minus x is 1, so expand up to d only. This a square get cancel r by p into what is the expansion of 1 upon 1 plus z, that is 1 minus z plus z square. So 1 minus z means 1 upon 1 minus d square by a square plus so on into l minus x. Okay, so what is this? This is r by p 1 into l minus x, that is l minus x only, because d square of l minus x means second derivative of l minus x is 0. Okay, and therefore solution, how we write y is equal to cf plus pi. So cf is c1 cos ax plus c2 sin ax plus r by p into l minus x. Okay, now at x equal to 0, here we have to take again conditions, boundary conditions, dy by dx is 0 and deflection is also 0, y equal to 0. So using this, we have to find c1 and c2. So y is this, if you differentiate y with respect to x, then dy by dx can be written as derivative of cos x is minus sin x, that is minus a c1 sin ax, and derivative of sin ax is cos x into a plus a c2 cos ax, and derivative of l minus x is minus 1, so minus r by p. Now suppose this is 1 and this is 2, so if we use these conditions in 1 and 2, then equation 1 becomes, here if you put y equal to 0, c1 cos 0, cos 0 is 1 plus sin 0 is 0 plus r by p into l minus 0. So what is the value of c1? Using this, c1 is equal to minus rl upon p. Okay, similarly in 2, if you put x equal to 0, dy by dx equal to 0, then we get 0 equal to here, sin 0 is 0, so first term is 0, plus a c2 into cos 0 is 1, minus r by p. So this implies a c2 is equal to r upon p, so c2 is equal to r upon ap. C2 equal to R upon AP, C1 equal to minus RL upon P, put in Y, and therefore we have to prove that Y equal to something, na? So y equal to c1, c1 is minus rl upon p cos ax plus c2 is r upon ap sin ax plus r by p into l minus x. Now what we have to prove? Our question was we have to prove that r by p into sin ax means we want r by p, so we can take r by p common here. And if you take r by p common, sin ax upon a, positive term first we will write sin ax upon a, then यहाँ से r by p common लिया तो minus l cos ax रहेगा and plus l minus x, so this is the required, okay. So in this way your unit number third is over here. In next video, we will start unit number 4, that is series solution of differential equation. Thank you so much for watching the video. Thanks.